So you guys had like two direct handovers?
Well, I had one direct handover in 36, 37. Actually, 37, 38.
So nine people.
Nine people. And then between 60 and 61, we had another direct handover.
Okay. And how did that work out?
So it was, the first time was different because last time it was two expedition crews handing over. And it was done on purpose because we were going to bring down, one crew brought up the Olympic torch and my crew brought it down. So we did a direct handover just for that.
That's right.
And so for about one week, we did a crossover with full expedition crews. So everybody was fully trained, and the only difference was that the guys that were coming in, that just said to wait somewhere around the station until we left our crew quarters. Mm. This time it was different because one of the astronauts was a short duration, and actually the handover was created just for that. So Hazza Al Mansoori was the first.
Sorry, guys.
Oh. Oh, it happens to everyone.
Such a cute music.
Yeah. See,
yeah, no, it's baby on. Music, Samantha. It's on tape.
That's all good. Keep on going.
And so this had been planned for quite a while. Mm-hmm. So together with the spacecraft arrived, new procedures. Everybody got orientation for the emergency procedures, specifically for the crew on nine.
But what does it mean? Yeah. Would you have responded to an emergency nine people? Did you have like roles figured out for nine
people? So, well, the thing is that because Hazza was going back down with a different crew, that was the main difference. So the crew that was going down would respond together with a different crew member, which was Hazza. So now they would disappear into their Soyuz. Okay. And the crew that was staying and the one that arrived and was staying, then they would become the new crew. But also,
I think
probably the same for Andy. Mm-mm. There was another switcheroo because Christina's seat was moved from one Soyuz to mine, and Drew's seat was moved to one Soyuz to another.
And do you guys do that right away? Move the seat liners?
Or I think it was done the day after arrival.
Okay.
It was timeline the day after.
Where would people sleep?
That's a good question. So, I was gonna ask.
So we had to come up with a way that made sense, because right afterward they had planned the arrival of SpaceX or HTV, one of the, I think it must have been HTV, was arriving right after that, and EVAs. So on the ground they wanted to give Jessica right away a crew quarter as soon as possible so that she could have her own things and sleep well, in case she had to do operations on the robotic arm or EVAs. And so Nick basically emptied out his crew quarter and left it empty, and they prepped it for Jessica's. And then Nick moved to Kibo. He was just living there.
But in an empty rack or just cabin volume?
In a cabin volume, and then he had all his stuff in the JPM.
Okay.
In the JLP, mm-hmm. All his personal stuff. And then at night he would just unfurl the sleeping bag in JPM and sleep there. For Hazza, the Russians built a crew quarter out of our shower curtains.
What do you mean out of the shower?
The blue ones?
Did they actually move?
No, the white ones. The new white washable ones. They grabbed some
extra ones.
Some extra ones. Oh, okay. Yeah, they grabbed some extra ones. They put them all together and made a little cubicle for.
In which
for
model? In which model?
I think he must have been in MIM 2.
Okay.
Yeah. He was in Eswatini, because that's the one without the spacecraft.
Okay.
So he was in Eswatini.